They are among our most vulnerable citizens, elderly, frail, mentally ill, unable to care for themselves. They are the residents of personal care homes. And a Team 4 investigation finds that in four of these places in Allegheny County, sex offenders registered with Megan's Law are also residing.
These residents are extremely vulnerable. They're under the same roof 24 hours a day with their neighbors who have complete access to them.
Team 4 discovered four registered sex offenders living at Woodland Manor Personal Care Home in Oakdale, according to the Megan's Law database administered by Pennsylvania State Police. But staff members refused to discuss it.
According to the state police, we've got four registered sex offenders living here.
No, we do not.
Ray Collins? He's upstairs right now, isn't he?
I can't violate these people's privacy, sir. You can't be here.
Raymond Collins, indecent assault. Paul Keyes, involuntary deviant sexual intercourse. Harold Moore, rape. Lawrence LeCocq, aggravated indecent assault on a 10-year-old girl. All of them list Woodland Manor as their residence with state police. And just a few weeks ago, a fifth registered sex offender moved into Woodland Manor, William Donald.
Very concerned. Very extremely concerned.
Mary Catherine Stofen is a mother of five who lives right next door to Woodland Manor.
I've seen him. This one here.
She didn't know until we told her that several registered sex offenders are living at Woodland Manor. But she was already worried.
Numerous times I've called finding people laying in my yard. There are patients over there. I don't understand how they can continue to continue.
What we didn't initially understand was how five registered sex offenders could all end up living at the same place. And then we discovered that the Allegheny County Department of Human Services placed all five offenders here after they got out of prison. Since 1999, the county has put 15 registered sex offenders at this facility and paid for their rent with tax dollars. It's part of a program called Max Out that places ex-cons who are diagnosed as mentally ill back into society. But is this really the best place to put sex offenders?
Because when you put predators in with the prey, somebody's going to get bit, and that's exactly what we're seeing time and again.
Wes Bledsoe is founder of aperfectcause.org, an Oklahoma-based national organization that has issued studies on the dangers of placing sex offenders in long-term care facilities.
We've found that residents have been murdered, raped, and sexually assaulted, as well as physically assaulted, by their roommates and the neighbors just down the hall, with no locked door between them and that criminal offender, all under the same roof.
Bledsoe says personal care home residents are especially vulnerable when they and their family members are not notified that sex offenders have moved in. And in Pennsylvania, there's no requirement that they be told.
I guess it's conceivable then that family members of residents of personal care homes would have no idea that there's four registered sex offenders living in this one facility.
I think you're right.
Stacy Watalik is spokeswoman for the department that oversees personal care homes in Pennsylvania.
We specifically look at staffing. Do you have enough staffing, whether it be as stringent as one-on-one staffing for that person, to ensure that they're not putting anyone else at risk and they're not putting themselves at risk?
But at Woodland Manor earlier this year, state inspectors issued 119 pages of violations, many of them staffing related, including one that states there was no verification that any of the staff had undergone the required training on resident rights and how to report abuse and neglect. The state has notified Woodland Manor that its license is not being renewed. At St. Luffald's personal care home in McKeesport, state inspectors are investigating complaints of physical abuse by residents inside the facility, including a resident rape allegation. And Team 4 found two registered sex offenders living here, though neither of them has been named as a target of the probe. Since 1999, County Human Services has placed 11 offenders at St. Luffald's. The state has served notice that it's revoking St. Luffald's license.
Is the department aware that there are two individuals living there who are on the Megan's Law website?
We are aware that there are individuals in the home that have raised potential concerns. We are aware of the sexual assaults that have taken place at the facility, and we are taking action.
But the state is taking no action to prohibit sex offenders from living in personal care homes, and Allegheny County continues to put them there.
It's like a train wreck. You can see that the bridge is out, you see the train is heading for the bridge that's out, and you know that there's going to be a train wreck. And that's exactly what we're seeing.
Now, Allegheny County Human Services Director Mark Cherna refused our repeated requests for an interview. But a spokeswoman for Cherna told us that none of the registered sex offenders that they've placed in personal care homes have committed another sex crime. That's what they tell us.